day at the zoo turned into a very graphic show and tell in Denmark. The carcass of a baby giraffe was fed to lions and to cougars in front of zoo attendees, including itty-bitty children. So let me just warn you now, the images for this story today are incredibly graphic, but we have to show them to you to tell the whole story. The 18-month-old giraffe was healthy, but according to officials at this Copenhagen zoo, the animal had to be euthanized because of European laws on inbreeding. Because you see, this giraffe here shared too many similar genes with other giraffes at the zoo. But this killing sparked a social media outrage. There was an online petition. But I want you to listen to this. This is the veterinarian explaining to the audience what has just happened.
This giraffe walked out here at 9:15. It was let out into its yard over there. Then there was a zookeeper with some rye bread. It really likes rye bread, and he said, "Here you go, Marius, here is some rye bread." I stood behind with a rifle, and when he put his head forward and ate the rye bread, then I shot him through the brain. It sounds violent, but it means that Marius had no idea of what was coming. He got his bread, then he died. I think this is very important. It's about how this has taken place.
Bengt Holst is the scientific director at the Copenhagen Zoo. He joins me now. Bengt, first, let me just begin with how the zoo killed this giraffe, shot it instead of lethal injection. Tell me why.
That's because if we shoot it, we can feed it to the carnivores afterwards. If we do it with an injection, we cannot feed it to anybody. Then we just have to dispose of the meat or just throw it away, which would be crazy.
But the choice to then pull out this massive knife and cut it up piece by piece, feed it to the lions in front of children. Why do that?
Because I think it's very important that we educate our kids and the adults also. And we had to do this autopsy anyway. And since the giraffe is so big, we can't keep it in the autopsy room. So we have to do it in the open anyway. And that gave us the opportunity to actually to invite people to see this autopsy and then to explain what they see, all the wonders of a giraffe. I mean, we all know a giraffe is wonderful on the savannah, but it's also a wonder inside with a heart as big. I mean, it's huge, the heart, so it can pump the blood up to the head, 2 meters up. And there are many wonders in the giraffe. And if we can educate people, tell this to the people, they get actually even more fascinated. I must say, it's not by accident people came by here. They were invited to go behind the scenes, so they had to choose to go there if they wanted to see this autopsy carried out.
I know this was voluntary. There was interest. Obviously, the kids' parents wanted them to be there. I understand you say educational, but I was listening to this interview on this network earlier today with one of the most respected wildlife experts in this country, Jack Hanna, and he does not agree. Take a listen.
And I'm a pretty fun-going person. You see me do TV. But this right now is the most abominable, insensitive, ridiculous thing I've ever heard of.
Abominable, sir, and insensitive. I know you know about the outrage. Respond to that and help me understand what exactly you are teaching these kids as they're watching pieces of a giraffe being eaten.
Well, first I must say that, for the autopsy first, it was actually the kids mostly that dragged their parents to this place. And, I mean, this is a unique opportunity to show what a giraffe is also inside. When will you ever be able to show that in another way? And I think it's not bad to show kids how the real wild is, or how the real nature is. We should be careful not to make the nature into a Disney world where animals are always alive and they're always sweet, etc., etc. This is the real thing. And when we then feed it to the lions afterwards, I mean, this is just either we feed them a horse or a cow. They have to get their meat. They're carnivores. And now we could feed them a giraffe. I don't see any problem in that. I mean, this is what's happened in Africa. It can happen in Copenhagen as well. And I think the kids, they need to see sometimes what the real world is. And they don't, it's not harmful anyway. It's what they need to know about.
It was the real world indeed, Bengt Holst with the Copenhagen Zoo. Thank you so much, sir, for explaining the zoo's perspective. I appreciate it.